Okay, JK1, this is for you. A little bit on the Wing Chun movement with the hip snapping. It's not specific to Wing Chun and core JKD. We've developed this to a high level. So when we're doing this, when I set my hand down on top of the pad while my student is holding it, I snap the hip as a chain effect from the foot. So the foot turning in helps rotate the knee, helps turn the hip. I'll do a little video on that also, you'll see the effect. But what happens is we go through here, this is the end of the chain. So this is we're not even thinking of the arm, we have to be completely relaxed. So when we do that, that sends the force of our hips, our whole body through the strike. Has to be completely relaxed, has to have the hand in it just nice. Fingers are just fluid, there's no tension in this, and I basically send it from my hip through to the center of my palm into the target in a straight line. That's very important. That's the one.
I felt that one on the inside.
Yes, you should. One of the other aspects and benefits of that relaxed hip snapping is, yes, it does go into your other kicks, punches, elbow strikes, everything else. All of it is generated from a relaxed hip. If I'm coming through and just firing from here or from this side, it's hip generated. If I throw a hook, I'm out like this. It comes from the hip first, and it comes around. That relaxed movement, rotation, again, aided by the foot turning, the knee turning in, hip snapping, shoulder rotating at the same time as you come around here and pop the punch in. And that's the same thing as whether I'm doing jab or a cross. If I do the cross, that snaps, and it comes right through the punches. So it really enhances. So if you're training the Wing Chun type one-inch punch, which is really what that is, resting the hand and sending it through, there's no drawback. That's from a relaxed posture, relaxed body that snaps from the ground up to the hip to the hand last. So that's what that's all about. So that transfers for when you're coming for some powerful punches. It means we use less time to throw the punch because we've got less travel. And we don't telegraph. We can fire from here, right from this spot to the target. And what people will do, invariably, you'll see them set up their three count before they strike, or they'll draw back to throw that. You don't have to draw back to get power in your punch. You have to have good body mechanics from the ground up and a relaxed body to transfer that to the target in a straight line. Relax. If you're not relaxed, it's like this. You can see the difference. One that goes out with power and speed, and the other one that's it's inhibiting itself. JK1, that was for you, so, or JK, I'm not sure how you pronounce it. I hope that worked for you really well. Pass it around, get more subscribers, because that's going to help me produce a lot more videos for you. We've got a lot more in the pipeline, and we'll get them out as fast as we can. I've got my student who is also a instructor in training. You get to see a lot more pain on her face if you subscribe and get more subscribers, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy that too. Take care.